Oh, Christmas is coming. My birthday is coming. I want to get one. Oh, look at this. Okay, I'm going to buy it.
Fed up delivery.
Hi, Mr. Liu, right?
Yeah, here's your delivery.
Oh, oh, thank you. Thank you.
Later.
I think it's time to get the jacket. This jacket is a little old. Oh, this looks nice. Okay, I forget this.
Eh? I thought I just delivered to this place yesterday.
Later.
In a globalized world, communications with another person is near instantaneous. While all of us are leveraging on the improvement in technology, we fail to realize our impact on the environment. Online purchases, imports and exports allow many economies to develop, but it has also created mass amount of carbon footprints. Today, we will talk about logistics, which accounted for 13% of the world's carbon emissions. Logistics activities comprises of material handling, storage, transport, and inventory management. Efficient and effective green efforts to improve the flow of products and information from one place to another can significantly impact the environment. Prior to the emphasis of environmental sustainability, mode of transport such as cars and cargo freight often produces large amount of black smoke whenever they are travelling. One example would be cars without catalytic converters, which is used to combust unburned carbon monoxide and hydrocarbons into less harmful carbon dioxide. While carbon dioxide still contributes to carbon footprint, it is considered to be less harmful. Cargo ships powered by dirty fuel leaves brown haze across ports and shipping lanes. These emissions contain high content of sulfur, which contributes to breathing problems, inflammation, and heart diseases. According to an article by Daily Mail, it was noted that 16 of the world's largest ships emit as much lung-clogging sulfur as the total population of the cars in the world. With that, we should realize how our environment can be negatively affected by our logistics activities alone. Besides that, environmental unfriendly packaging, such as bubble wraps, to protect the products ordered by consumers, also contributed to carbon footprint. Excessive use of plastics and non-biodegradable materials to transport products contribute to environmental issues such as global warming and the use of less developed countries as landfills. Lastly, companies fail to close the loop to recycle used products and packaging, which can still be reused or remanufactured. One of the examples would be beverage companies, where not many companies will recycle and reuse their bottles or cans. And even if they do, if they could collect it themselves, it reduces the number of trips to transfer these bottles to the company. As such, lesser carbon would be produced. Before we look at the green initiatives, let us define what is a fact and what is a fad. A fact is a truth known by actual experience or observation, while a fad is a temporary fashion, notion, or manner of conduct. With a clear idea on what is a fact and what is a fad, let us look at some examples of green logistics. Practicing of green logistics can help to reduce the environmental impact. So what exactly is green logistics? Unlike conventional logistics, green logistics aim to reduce environmental externalities and aim to achieve a balance in economy, social, and environmental objectives. Next, we will take a look at Panasonic Japan green initiatives. Panasonic improves its load factor by reducing the size of their packaging and introduced joint transportation, which increases the number of the items transported and reduces the number of trips made. This in turn reduces the carbon emission from transportation. Besides that, Panasonic also shifts from conventional transportation methods such as air freight and uses railroad transport and shipping. In 2015, the results of these initiatives of railroad freight transportation within Japan helped to reduce 7,013 tons of carbon dioxide emissions. Furthermore, in 2015, Panasonic jointly entered into a full recycling scheme for used stretch film with nozzle. This stretch film used by Panasonic Transport was previously discarded by them, but is now recycled by nozzle and sold back to Panasonic. This reduces logistics waste, and Panasonic recycled a total of 62 tons of stretch film in 2015. In 2011, Maritime Singapore Green Initiative seeks to reduce the environmental impact of shipping through Green Port Program. This initiative seeks to encourage ocean-going ships calling at Singapore's port to reduce emission of pollutants by using approved scrubber technology or burn clean fuels on their ocean-going ships. Qualifying ships will receive 25% reduction in port fees. Besides that, on a regional level, there is the ASEAN Corporate Sustainability Summit, where thought leaders and sustainability experts share with government and non-government organizations the most innovative and impactful sustainability practices. This will help to inspire more organizations to embrace sustainability development, and hence all businesses in the region will move towards becoming environmentally friendly. So, do we consumers have a role to play in green logistics? The answer is yes. For example, customers can choose to ship under UPS carbon neutral option, and a fee will be collected based on the amount of carbon from the shipment. and the amount collected will be invested in environmentally responsible projects such as reforestation. As consumers, we should choose to buy from companies that have green practices, not limited to green logistics. When a company practices green logistics, the initial efforts will in turn create benefits and results in positive returns in the long run. With the positive returns, more people and company will be enticed to practice green logistics. This will then form a repetitive cycle, creating more and more benefits from practicing green logistics. Starting off with the effects of practicing green logistics. By practicing green logistics, the amount of harmful emissions from vehicles will be reduced. Proper planning to maximize each trip of delivery can reduce the number of trips and effectively reduce the amount of harmful substances emitted from the burning of fuels. In 2011, Walmart's practice of effective logistics planning managed to save up to 86,600 trips and nearly 3.2 million miles, avoiding 41,000 tons of carbon dioxide emissions or taking off 7,900 cars off the road. This led to a 69% improvement of Walmart's delivery efficiency. By saving on the number of trips to be taken, the amount of fuel demanded from deliveries will decline. An average reduction of 7 to 25% of fuel and decreasing operating costs by 15 to 20%. With the decreased number of trips to be taken and shortened time where the vehicle's engines are operating, the amount of pollutants emitted from the exhaust will decrease. Naturally, this would mean lesser pollution. Furthermore, the practice of green logistics helped to maximize the number of deliveries made per trip, which reduces the number of trips to be taken on a daily basis, consequently saving many trips and fuel. On average, according to a study by Cranfield University, the average savings is approximately 6%. Similarly, if we look at Walmart, they were able to save up to 86,600 trips and nearly 3.2 million miles, which translates to huge savings for the company. This will also mean that the companies would not have to jack up the prices to end consumers. With the lowered cost and efficient deliveries, customers would definitely be more happy to do business with you. Moreover, according to a study by Nielsen, 66% of surveyed customers were more likely to support companies that adopt practices that give back to the society than one who don't. As a result, this will then create strong brand equity and customer loyalty. Lastly, for the ending results of green logistics. The decrease in emissions would lead to health benefits. Particularly compelling is the experience in Dublin. After the ban on coal burning in 1990, studies there showed prompt and substantial improvements in respiratory health. In the US, improvements in air quality during the 1980s and 1990s have been estimated to be responsible for as much as 15% of the overall increase in life expectancy. As mentioned previously, with the decrease in cost, increase in customer satisfaction and brand loyalty, the companies practicing green logistics would experience increasing profits over time. With that, we can see the complete benefit cycle of practicing green logistics.
Okay, sorry, 就好。